paradox right there. Yeah. He's letting you know that the things that you go through, the suffering, the trials, that ain't nothing compared to what God is going to do in your life and my life if we just allow him to say, Lord, have your way now.
Yes.
Tired of running. I'm tired of trying to do things on my own.
Tired.
I'm tired of trying to fight God and fight his word and fight the preacher.
Yeah.
I'm tired of trying to do it my way. I don't have enough. Some of us have got our tails whooped by God and the devil because we continue to try to do it our way. But how many of you know that Jesus says, not my will, but that thine will be done? See, if you notice something, he's here, there you got the Son of God, who, if anybody could have got up and say, I ain't got to do it this way, I'm going to do it my way. But he said, not my will, let thine will be done. Letting you know is that he even know, being God himself in flesh, but know that he can't do it even on his own. And so how much more of us need to learn and understand the will of God? Where do we fit in this plan? Lord, what would you have me to do? How many of us pray and say, Lord, where do I fit in even in this church? Should I be an usher? Should I be a deacon? Should I be this? Should I be that? But instead, we're so caught up busy with the world, trying to live in the world and be impressed, impress the world, and we're finding ourselves at a point where we are just finding ourselves just being in the sea of just doing nothing.
Uh-huh.
But it's time to work now, saints.
Yeah.
And see, that's what God, when you talk about this paradox, a paradox will run you crazy if you're not careful. If you study many of the Old Testament prophets, David, and you talk about the prophets of old, some of them had to go through wilderness experiences. And sometimes those experiences weren't easy and they weren't pleasant. But see, because they trusted God and they had a resolve in themselves, and that resolve simply says that no matter what may happen, my trust is in the Lord. I wonder if there's someone out there who also has made up your mind that even with all the paradoxes and even all the different conflicts and even with all the different arguments that the world may throw at us and present to us, but in spite of, I'm going to serve the Lord. That's why when there was a conflict during the time of Joshua, when the people said they got caught up in idolatry, caught up this, that, and whatever, but it was Joshua who made the statement, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And see, that's what you got to do when you're with your paradox. Your paradox is sending you conflict, but you got to be able to respond with resolve. And that resolve it simply is that no matter what may happen, I'm going to serve the Lord. No matter what trouble may come, I'm going to continue to lift up holy hands.
Hallelujah.
Come, that God is still real in my life. No matter what may come, no matter what may present, I'm going to stay with the Lord. I'm going to
Hallelujah.
Because I recognize if it had not been for the Lord who is on my side, where would I be? And God is telling you today that you got to hold on to his unchanging hand. Stand and believe that God is able. Go with a surety that God is working for you. That he's on your side. That no weapon that's formed against you, it shall not be able to prosper. You got to trust the Lord. You got to trust his Bible. And know that with a surety, God is on my side.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, I trust you. Though I'm going through a tough time and a tough battle, but the Lord said, I'm still with you. You got to hold on to this thing. Don't give up on God. Don't turn around. Don't get discouraged or get despondent. But get in your mind. Make up your mind and say, Lord, I'm going to stay with you. Make up your mind and say, Lord, in spite of, God, you're still good. God, you're still real. God, your holiness still matters. My life still is in your hands. You're going to bring me out on time. You're going to fix my present and my situation. Listen, your paradox, your plight may be saying one thing, That's what that scripture was saying.
That's right.
Paul is saying, my plight is saying, I'm down and out.
Yeah.
But your